Ever since I was young, I wanted to be a fighter.
All right, here he is, the number one lightweight contender, making his way to the octagon and looking to lead as the new undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world.
I just had this anger in me ever since it happened. Fighting was the only way I could release these demons.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
I always dreamed of being in the UFC or something, fighting the best.
UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City.
So here we go. This highly anticipated fight is now underway.
Good to drag the fight. So take him down. There you go.
Oh, how about the slam? Position there on the ground.
Oh, he's hurt him. He's hurt him.
He's got him here. He's got him for very bad. Now he has to fight. Very careful. Hanging out.
Shot a double there.
Oh, man. The canvas is shaking as he slipped.
Let him up. Go get him.
The cover changed now.
He went single into high class. He's taking this dude for a ride.
The thing about fighting is, things can change in the blink of an eye.
He's out!
He got him!
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So, a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. All right, DC, no telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance.
His best performance to date in the biggest moment. In the biggest moments, you got to show up, and that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every
play to win.
Of joy and hard to play.
To understand my story, I gotta take you 10 years back. Growing up in my neighborhood, some people make it out, but a lot don't. Everybody's trying to be somebody, and they're willing to do anything to get what they want. You got gangs, drug dealers, killers, and crime. You gotta watch your back in these streets, because if you don't, there's always somebody trying to snake you. See, my father fell victim to these streets. He was known throughout the hood as the money man. And he never really was home much because he was always working. But he did what he could do to provide for me. Now, I don't know all of what he did, but I could take a few guesses. He had never had a real job, but I still admired him because I never missed a meal. Now the night he was killed, I was told it was routine. Make a play and stop and get the word in with the guys. Little did he know what was about to happen. Rumor is he was set up. But someone claiming he had been working with the feds and giving them information. And he was also working with rival neighborhood gangs, trying to better his clientele. The word was spread, and one phone call was made, and it turned the whole hood against him. He got back in his car and they let him have it. There was bullets, blood, and people everywhere. He was involved in a shootout, and of course he didn't make it out. It was told he suffered 8 gunshot wounds, and he died. So here's where the story turns to me. Ever since my father's passing, my mom isn't really home much, so I was basically on my own. A normal 17-year-old starts his day with breakfast, some cereal, and goes to school. But see, school wasn't for me. I hated class, and I couldn't focus. So I skipped and got into trouble. And you can blame it on the absence of my father, but I'm filled with so much anger, I was willing to fight anybody who spoke on my name or my father's name. That led to me getting into a lot of fights, getting in trouble. But I didn't care. See, that incident got me 3 months in a juvenile jail. I couldn't take it in there. I was so happy when I got out. But when I got out, I was ready to turn my life around. Living out on my own now, I had to find a way to make some money. And I don't know about working in no fast food place. You know, with no education, high school dropout, no skills, what am I gonna do? So I go outside, and I see a sign posted up talking about a reward for a backyard fight. That's one thing I knew I could excel at. I get money to fight people. I was fighting people for free and getting disciplined for it. So you're telling me I can get rewarded for it? So I went in and I got ready. It was supposed to be 3 fights with $500 rewards each. So I trained my body to be ready for these fights. And I beat every opponent I had with ease. I was showing off power and speed that I didn't even know I had. It was so impressive. I attracted the attention of a trainer. He ended up inviting me to his gym.
Hello? Anybody home?
And we went straight to work.
You daydreaming again? It was one of those, let's say, amateur cards you can find across town from time to time. Great fights, never know if you're gonna see something.
He had said he had been watching me. So he was already impressed with what
look
I could
who
do.
It is. Hey, welcome to my gym, where champions are made.
He basically got me together. Since he was a professional at it, he was handling a lot of the training I had, a lot of the fights I was going to have later on. He set me up in an amateur tournament.
First real amateur fight. I don't count that last one because you weren't training with me, all right? Remove that from your memory. Your journey starts right here.
I could tell he had faith in me. I didn't want to let him down. So my first fight was just impressive as the rest, showing off power and skill. I ended the fight in the first round with a knockout, a technical knockout at that one. It was set up for me to have four fights. The second fight was much like the first one. A similar looking opponent, similar style. So I came out the gate firing. Uppercuts, overhands. Showing them that I had speed and power. Showing that I was not a fluke. But I ended the second fight with a kick to the head. Third fight was a lot different. In the third fight, I had to deal with a wrestler, somebody I've never dealt with before. In the streets, we don't wrestle, we just use hands. So it was a little bit complicated. But I got through it, and I won that fight as well. This fight took a little bit longer. But I got the win by knockout. This opponent was a little bit harder. I had to give him everything. In the last fight, I was told that Dana White had showed up. But it was also another wrestler. And I struggled with dealing with takedowns. Because like I said, in the streets we don't do that. I caught him one time trying to reach in for a takedown. And I ended the fight. So that was four wins straight. And I knew how I gained the attention of Dana White. So happy with my success. I just let out a scream of enjoyment. My trainer was so proud of me because he knew how far I had come. And I earned my first MMA contract. All I had to do was sign on a dotted line. I finally made it out the hood. I'm getting paid for doing something I already knew how to do.